Hi.
Hello.
It's us.
I'm Anger
and I'm Solus
from
der kleine Hirnfick from Switzerland.
Which means the little brain fuck.
Here is this band you can see in the background.
And you know, in this little shitty country we live, there exists also like a secret police, which has like little secret files about artists, for example.
And it has also cool side effects, for example, when you don't know no more exactly what you've done, let's say 15 years ago or so, you can just go back to the files and check it out.
That's clever.
Yeah, and here we have such a file in a close-up, and you see, in 1985 I planned an art exhibition, and I also did some rock against racism. But the main thing we want to talk about here is that in 1983 we made together with other people a video film called Blutgeil.
The Wohlgrot here, the really big squat where in the end to 200 people live.
We used it for one part of the film. It has a real nice pissoir and you can see it.
On it off! On it off! Eisen on!
We also planned to make the first screening there, and we did that weeks before because we went on tour with our band. And then when we did this announcement, the situation in the Wohlgrot and around looked rather calm and good.
Peacefully, but when we came back from this tour, the whole situation suddenly had kind of changed.
Das Wohlgrot Areal beim Zürcher Hauptbahnhof ist heute geräumt worden. Spezialtruppen der Zürcher Polizei gingen gegen die autonome Kulturfabrik vor, buchstäblich von allen Seiten. Hans Haldimann berichtet.
Aber schon eine halbe Stunde später ist die Polizei mit einem Großaufgebot zur Stelle. Mit 200 bis 300 Mann. Angriff aus der Luft. Eine Antiterroreinheit wird herangeflogen, um die Dächer zu sichern. Die Polizei will verhindern, dass Besetzer Gegenstände hinunterwerfen oder allenfalls selber zu Boden stürzen. Plötzlich werden Zuschauer und Sympathisanten rabiat zurückgedrängt, ohne Vorwarnung. Auch nach Ablauf des Ultimatums ist der Eingang zur Fabrik offen geblieben. Trotzdem beginnt jetzt die generalstabsmäßig organisierte Räumung.
Unsere Devise war Räumen.
Bruno!
Und das ist bis jetzt gelungen. Und wieso sind Sie nicht einfach zur Tür rein, die offen war? Es hat wohl eine Tür gehabt, die offen war, aber Sie haben gesehen, es hat andere Räumlichkeiten, die verrammelt sind. Und wir haben ja nicht gewusst, was uns da innen erwartet.
Zuerst blieb es nach der Räumung des Zürcher Wohlgrot-Areals vom Dienstag ruhig. Diesen Abend kam es jetzt zu massiven Ausschreitungen.
Ein beträchtlicher Teil der Demonstranten suchte darauf die Deckung der verwinkelten Gassen im Niederdorf, viele offensichtlich mit gewalttätiger Absicht. Die Polizeieinheiten waren hier ohne Chance. Vor allem im Bereich von Mühlegasse und Hirschenplatz kam es zu Szenen, die an die schlimmsten Nächte von 1980 erinnerten.
Journalists of Swiss newspaper Blick gave their copy of Blutgeil to the police, to the spokesman Bruno Kissler, whom we've seen before. Bruno, as a loyal officer, suddenly gave the cassette further to his commandant, who watched it in his office. Then got first red in his face and afterwards very pale. Then he took a deep breath and
grabbed the telephone and called his boy.
It was not only the 15 policemen Without uniforms and civil from the PMS, it was also about 15 policemen from the riot brigade with gas grenades and rubber bullet guns.
And even anti-terror troops with machine guns.
In the heat of the battle, they forget to check the list of squatted houses properly and went to our neighbors also, a respectable family with little children.
And what they confiscated? Yes, a bag full of child books.
Before they got it, they were in the wrong house.
After the raid, they accused us of portrayal of violence. The police made a press conference, and the next day in the media, we had bad press.
So we had to do something about it, and we started writing faxes and organizing press conferences ourselves, explaining once again that our video wasn't a brutal or as they told, but a comedy, and they're just too stupid to see that.
And this guy we also know from the TV is the state prosecutor, and he wants us 4 months to go to jail.
Finally arrived the big day of the trial. Real life comedy or not, it took place exactly 1 year after the eviction of the Wolgroth. And here you have one more chance to glance at these special shock troops.
Especially this young, juicy policeman demonstrated how to use your club right.
And not just that, he's also glancing over here. It took 3 months until they let us know what the jury exactly decided.
Der im Zürcher Untergrund entstandene Videofilm Blutgeil verstößt nicht gegen den sogenannten Brutalo-Artikel des Strafgesetzes. Das Gericht hielt fest, dass es sich bei Blutgeil um eine geschmacklose Satire und nicht um realistische Gewaltdarstellung handle.
Well, it came as it has to come. The state's prosecutor promptly lodged an appeal, and 1 year later we all met again before the next higher court.
And now, before your very eyes, TV Stop proudly presents from inside the courtroom with our candid camera. Here is the state attorney
himself. Amongst others, he declared that our video contains the most cruel scenes of violence ever possible.
They sentenced us to pay a fine and thousands of Swiss francs for all the trials they made. The cost of this real-life comedy show was in total more than $150,000.
And all this theater only because of a tiny small trash film worth about 1,000.
Jetzt ist er endlich durch. Endlich ist der Arsch durch!